Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Kanika Jain this side, and in this video we shall be talking about the floral heart window die from Dress My Craft and different ways to use, and as well we will be creating a quick and easy card. So let's get started. So this is how the floral heart window background die looks like, and this is one of the background dies which Dress My Craft has launched. So the link to buy all these craft supplies is mentioned in description box, so you can check that out. So this is how the die looks like, and on the back side here you can see Dress My Craft is written. And while talking about the size, this measures 4.5 inches by 5.5 inches approximately, and from center it will be hollow, so you can use it as a photo frame as well. So I created some of the projects already, but some I'll be creating in this video as well. So this is how the die cut comes. So here you can see the die cut on white cardstock. This is how the die cut comes and looks on the golden mirror cardstock. As well, make sure to hit the subscribe button if you haven't already yet. So now let's move on and see how to die cut using this heart floral window background die, and how you can create easy cards with these. So here is one of the inspiration which I already created, and this is how my card looks like. Isn't this card looking beautiful? If you like this card, then do hit the like button as well. And when you see this card, the background is as well created by myself using distress inks and stencils. So what I did was I used the Dress My Craft stencil, the straight line stencil. I used this stencil and I just worked with my distress inks and then created this background. And after creating the background, I simply had done die cutting, which later in this video I'll as well show. So now moving on to the next card, here you can see what I did. I simply took red cardstock, I die cut as per the design, and then with help of my fussy cutting scissor, I randomly took 1/4 inch gap and had cut the heart out of it. So it's like with the help of just one die you can create multiple things. So now moving on to the next card, this is how my next card looks like. So I simply stamped in the center and I played with my distress inks for the background, and then here you can see I have used the Dress My Craft sequence to embellish it, and here I have used the scalloped border punch from Dress My Craft, and this is how the punch looks like. So I used this punch on the top and on the lower portion of the die cut paper, and then I simply added another die. I used the couple and heart die. So this is how the couple and heart die looks. So what I did, I took the couple out of this and I just simply had done die cutting on a red and white cardstock using my Easy Cuts machine. So these were the three cards which I had already made. So now let's move on to the fourth card which I'll be making now. So for that, here I'm using the Dress My Craft Romantic Roses paper pad. That's the 12 by 12 paper, and I'll be using this particular sheet. And the link to buy all these craft supplies is mentioned in description box, so do check that out as well. So before I do the die cutting, I shall trim off my paper so that it fits in my Big Shot exactly. So here I am just taking a little bit extra paper so that I can easily place my floral heart background die. And here I am using my Dress My Craft paper trimmer, and I have simply cut down my paper, and now I'll be just creating sandwich onto my Sizzix Big Shot, and then I'll run it twice, that is to and fro, and I'll get the perfect die cut. And And here you can see how quickly the die cutting is done. So now I shall take out my die cut from this, and for that here I'm using the ultimate die cleaning tool to just get out rid of the excess die cut which has stuck in my die. This ultimate die cleaning tool is a must have tool for any crafter, as this makes your work very easy and saves a lot of time. And here you can see how crisp die cutting we have already got. So now let's move on to the next step, and for that what we'll be doing is I'll be just simply distressing the edges of this using a distress tool like this. So here you can see I have already done the distressing. Now what I'll be doing is on the back side I'll be using 3D foam tape, as I want to give a little dimension. So here I have applied a 3D foam tape, and then if you want to place your card like this in a tilted way, you can do. If you want to add some dimensions or some edges, you can do that. But for now, for this one, what I'll be doing is I'm simply adding it on the note card. Now I'll be taking up my Teflon bone folder and I'll be nicely pressing it down so that both the base and the die cut get stuck very well. And after this, what I'll be doing is here I'm taking up the Dress My Craft Word dies. These are the sentiment dies and they have got several sentiments, but today I'll be using the Miss You sentiment, and using my easy cuts I have done some die cutting already on a red cardstock, and this is how it looks. Now at the center of the heart I'll be simply placing both of these sentiments like this, and just I'll add a little bit of more element to my card. So for that here I'm using the red hearts. These are the little hearts and they have the red, like they have three different colors in this. They are a mixture of white, baby pink and red, but I'll be using the red one. And here you can see I'm using the Dress My Craft tweezers. These tweezers just simply are amazing, as what I'll be doing is I'm just picking up my sentiment with the help of tweezer. I'm applying the adhesive and then I'm nicely pressing it down. As this sentiment is a little intricate, so these tweezers make my work very easy, and then there is no chance that my hand would get stained with the adhesive. And tada, our card is ready. So I hope that you enjoyed this tutorial and loved watching the tutorial of this card. So you can see that this heart, that's the floral heart background window die, is just amazing, and you can create a lot of variations with this floral heart window background die. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you are creating any of the projects using these products, then do tag us on social media. We would love to see and repost them. So I hope that you enjoyed watching this tutorial. See you soon. Until next time, till then, happy crafting.